I've threatened a couple of times now to move a big chunk of my collection that's really anchored in First Bowman Chrome cards of players that I don't really want to PC. Really purge the prospecting part of my collection to reinvest and pick up cards of players that I want to keep in the PC. So today is the latest point on my journey to making that happen. I wanted to show you guys those cards before I packaged them up and sent them off to Four Sharp Corners and DC Sports Cards 87. I'm Cardi-C. If you guys have not been by the channel before, welcome and thank you for stopping by. On the channel, we explore ways to grow your sports card collection and potentially make some money along the way by gaining a deeper understanding of the hobby. So if you enjoyed today's content, make sure to hit that thumbs up button, consider subscribing for future content, and make sure to hit that notification bell to get alerts every time I release a new video. All right, so without further ado, let's flip the camera around and take a look at the cards that are going out this week. So I got two sets of cards that I'm sending out for consignment. This first stack here is going to DC Sports Cards 87. I believe they actually do more volume than PWCC or Probstein, which is impressive when you think of it. This is the first time I'll be submitting or consigning with them. And then I have a stack of graded cards and a box of wax that we'll run through that I'm sending into Four Sharp Corners. They started off in auction consignment business, and they have some pretty good promotional rates going on. So I committed at the start of the year to moving some of my Bowman cards and sort of just reworking my inventory to align with what I want with my collection. So that's what these sales, these cards that I've selected for consignment are going to be. So first up, the pile that is going to DC Sports Cards 87. We have the 2018 gold parallel of Miguel Andujar. This is from Series 1. Andujar never really bounced back after all the injuries in 2018. I thought that he was going to be the Yankees' heart of the order guy in 2020, and he didn't really live up to the hype. So we'll see what happens with Andujar's future in New York, but I'm gonna move that and try and make a couple bucks off of it. Jose Urquidy, this is the black parallel, numbered out of 69. Again, this was a card I purchased off of Blowout, thinking I'd be able to flip it pretty quickly. Thinking that Urquidy was going to be a middle to top end of the rotation starter for the Astros very quickly. He settled into that 4 or 5 role, but the market activity has not been great. Now, this is a card I pulled from 2018 Topps update. It's the Glaber. I don't even know what the, I think it's Salute. Anyways, it's a rookie Glaber auto. If you guys have been around the channel, you know that I'm a Red Sox fan. It's a cool auto sticker, but just doesn't have a fit for my collection anymore. So sending that off. This card was something that I picked up for the Cardi-C Learns to Flip series. Nick Madrigal, White Sparkle. He actually had a pretty good rookie campaign last year. He's one of these very high contact, low power, high on base percentage guys. Just again trying to move some Bowman cards, and that fits the bill there. Next up, we have some cards that I was originally looking to grade, but after further review, there was an imperfection on one of these that caused me to question sending them out. So these Lucianos I was picking up for $5 to $6 a pop at the beginning of last year, and now it's between a $25 and $30 card. So I'll move these out. I have a couple tucked away. I got a couple PSA slabs that I'm going to be hanging on to at least for a little bit. He is a stud prospect, but again, freeing up some cards in the Bowman Chrome inventory to move on to some other stuff I want for the collection. And that's what is the story with this guy here as well. This is Nolan Jones. He is the Indians' number one prospect. The Blue Wave Refractor auto numbered out of 150. I believe he's in the top 50 or just outside the top 50. But his cards haven't really gotten any love. I'm not being patient, but there's some cards coming up on the horizon that I really want to have some cash available for. So looking to move him. And then the last two cards are of Dylan Carlson. This is his base auto from 2016 Bowman Chrome. And then this is the Black Refractor auto, numbered out of 75. So Carlson debuted last year. He had some ups and downs, that's for sure. He finished the season on a high note. I'm in on this for, I think, 300 or so. And I'm pretty confident I can get close to the 500 range just by throwing it in an auction. There are some like minor surface scratches and like print defects on it, so hoping that nothing gets held up or there's the buyer doesn't go ahead and try and return it on me, but we'll see. And then the base auto, I'm in for like $100, I think, and this is now $150-$200. So just again, the theme of this video, putting Bowman cards together, selling them to put them into some other stuff that I'm interested in for the collection. So this is the stack that's going out to DC Sports Cards. I am recording this on Super Bowl Sunday, and it is snowing to beat the band. So we'll see if I'm able to make it out to the post office tomorrow. It might be Tuesday or Wednesday. So now, four sharp corners. I got this big old stack of slabs. Most of this stuff was on my slabs, but I'm trying to take advantage of sort of some of the market pricing right now. First up, we have 2015-16 Upper Deck Young Guns, Artemi Panarin. This is a true BGS 9.5 Plus, Gem Mint Plus. I actually picked it up off of my slabs for like $100, and this is a $175 to $200 card. So I would really like a Pasternak and a Marchand Young Gun card. Panarin's good, but he's not someone I want a PC. That's an easy $50 to $75 flip. A couple of these guys I had graded myself last year. Alec Bohm, PSA 10. I had missed. So my PSA order came back like a week or two after the Rookie of the Year awards were announced, and Bohm was a finalist. He should have won, in my opinion, but if I could have gotten these cards back before that, I could have moved them for $115, $120 a piece, but now they're probably $85 to $100. So gonna ask four sharp corners to list them for me and see what I can get through auction. Next up, 1989 Fleer, Ken Griffey Jr. in a PSA 9. This is one of his more affordable rookie cards, something that I picked up when I got into the hobby, or back into the hobby. Just not something I really want for the PC anymore. So moving that, we got another familiar face, Dylan Carlson. This is just his base Bowman Chrome in a PSA 10. It's been a wild ride holding on to these Dylan Carlson cards, but I'm ready to part ways with them. Next up, Carter Kieboom, PSA 9. Similar to Miguel Andujar, he had his chance in 2020 to prove his worth to the Nationals, and he didn't have the best time doing it. I'm trying to move it just because he's not a core part of the PC. Can you guys sense a theme here? Next up, we have the 2018 Topps Series 2 Glaber SP. This is in a PSA 9. A lot of these cards, too, I had picked up at one point for the sole purpose of, like, trying to flip and move them. I'm quickly learning that that's not the best approach to take. I'd rather spend money on cards that I want for the collection, and if I move them down the line and they appreciate in the process, so be it. But this is a distant, distant second behind the Ronald Acuna bat down. When Glaber was heating up, I picked this card up for around $100 or so, thinking that it could follow the Acuna bat down, but not quite. Next are some SGC cards. First up, we have another familiar face. We actually have two. Marco Luciano, SGC 10s. I got caught up in the SGC craze, as did everyone in the May 2020 timeframe. I wish that I had sent these into PSA, because these are $125, $150 cards in a PSA 10. There's not really many comps for the SGC 10, but I peg it at, I don't know, 75, 80% of what the PSA 10 is worth. So moving some of those guys. And then we have a couple of Julio Rodriguez. He actually is higher on the prospect lists that just came out than Marco Luciano. He is at number 4, I believe, depending on which list you look at. But this is his base Bowman Chrome from 2019. And then you have the Mojo Refractor, both in an SGC 10. Again, I have some PSA versions of these cards, so I'll move the SGC ones, take the money I can get, and move them into a bigger card. And then last up for slabs, we have the 2019 Bowman Chrome Refractor of Andrew Vaughn. He's pretty firmly in sort of the number 2 first baseman prospect, now behind Spencer Torkelson. Just like a prototypical corner infielder, power hitting middle of the lineup guy. He's really slow and he's got decent fielding. So we'll see if the White Sox end up moving on from Jose Abreu in the next couple years to make some room for him. But I got a few other cards of Andrew Vaughn, so I'll move the Refractor SGC 10. And then I'm also going to be sending along this box of Allen and Ginter X. This is from 2020. I don't believe in the 2020 draft class. You have Yordan, Bo Bichette, Kyle Lewis, I think Arozarena's in here. They're just, I don't know. I'm not sold on any of the players. And if I'm going to be buying wax to hold on to for the long term, I want there to be a chase player that has the potential to be the Mookie Betts or the Mike Trout of sort of this next generation. So we got some wax that I'm sending along to four sharp corners. We got these slabs I'm sending along to four sharp corners, and then this stack of short prints, autographs, singles that we're sending along to DC Sports Cards 87.